love me. As a friend.
As a brother.
It's the worst answer.
Just jump. Have you ever had a friendship breakup?
Yes.
How was that?
It was very, very tough. I think it probably almost hurt as much as a breakup.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
Hey girls, welcome to my channel. I need lip balm. I have a very simple, okay, kind of simple face bead, hair just held back like that. My fiance and I are going on a really pretty date and I thought of wearing something spicy. Let's look at it. Sometimes you do have those days when our apartment is just not put together, but I think I am beautiful too. Hello. One thing about Sweden, people will stare at you, like they will stare. But would they say a word? No. I was seated at the train and then this guy was seated right next and that guy was, he was like this. So I looked at him and I was also like this. And then we just stared at each other. And then when I stood up, he was still like this. I'm just like, oh my God, you guys are so weird. However, I must give it to the Swedish women though. Like, Swedish women will tell you you look good. Like, that's for sure. Anywho, so to the hope I don't fall down. I think that it's very important, like, even though you guys are like engaged and everything is there, still going on these cute dates are just super sweet. And then that's what we're doing. So I came from my house. He's coming from his house. And we're meeting. Oh my God, and the thing I have under my wig is so tight, it's giving me a freaking headache. So I just shamelessly push it behind. Because there's no way. Guys, I'm sorry. If my wig is receding after this, there's no way. See you later. But that was giving me a proper headache. I was just like, so how important is friendship for you?
It's super important, I think. Not just in a relationship, but like in general, I think it's really important to have friends.
When you move abroad, people tend to, or we tend to get lonely and kind of desperate for connections. And everybody, honestly, everybody definitely has a story to tell. And today I have a story to tell. I had a friend that really hated me, whether it was calling me fat, like I just got comfortable actually being her ugly friend and I was okay with it. Speaking ill of me to people that knew me, people that she barely knew, my ex-friends, just anyone, she did not miss a chance to put me down. And her hatred towards me came in the most passive way. It was really hard to tell. But all I noticed was her silence whenever I was doing good. Like she could go for long without talking to me and then come back. And if I was down, then she would be really there for me, which made me really like her because I felt like she understood me and I could speak to her on days that I was low. And it was really comforting. I also noticed that the men that she was dating used to hate me so much and I did not really understand why, like where the hatred was coming from and so on, until everything just came down. And when I tell you it came down raining, so bad. And at that point, it became very clear to me that my friend really, really hated me. It became cold so quickly. Guys, you know, I was in the midst of telling you this, my horror stories with friends, and I still want to talk to you guys about this. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is not to put anybody down, but more just to like let you know if you're going through something similar, I want to give you hope at the end of this. But also, you know, there's this story of this lady, Shanquella. Oh my God, these names, Shanquella Morrison. Yeah, I put her here, and she was basically, allegedly, unalived by her friends when they were on vacation. And I almost felt like this is something that I could almost relate to, considering the kind of friendships I've had with some individuals. But first, let me have something nice. Let me have something sweet, so don't be bitter, okay? Oh, perfect. It seems like a lot of people working from here, all the youngins, the Gen Zs, we are working outside. Ah, good. So now we're gonna talk. Oh, so good. Talking to you guys about like friendship breakups and friendship heartbreaks, and when I tell you that one of the hardest breakups I ever had to go through was breaking up with someone who was my friend for so long, and I swear to God, well, the way I loved this girl, I thought we are going to create a hell of heaven together. I loved her so much. I would have given her my right kidney if she needed one. And the way our friendship ended was so traumatic for me. Like, it was so traumatic for me. I had to heal, literally heal, because it was that hard. I'm not here to like come and tell you, oh, cut people off or all that stuff. In fact, I feel like when you're in a position to just cut somebody off, you're pretty good. When you really break up with a friend, it is so freaking hard and it's so painful and it's very lonely, because at least this particular person, like, she was my person. I called her at any slight inconvenience. She was my person with everything. I still love her so much, so that I can never speak about her in a way that you can tell who I'm talking about. And don't try guessing, because you don't know who I'm talking about. But right now, we're making pancakes. I got blood on my hands right now, and I'm stumbling through the dark in the dawn. I have found new ways, but no, I can't be the one that you need. Relationships and friendships definitely do share one thing in common. Longevity doesn't always equal success. And I think that this narrative of, oh, my day ones and so on, okay, cool with your day ones, but sometimes your day ones are the most toxic. They've been toxic from day one, and it's okay to get new friends. Maybe they might not last 20 years like your day one, but at least the 2 years, the 1 year, the 6 months that you were friends, it was very nourishing and it was good friendships, and that's perfectly fine. When you come to the understanding that the value of friendship is not necessarily on longevity, it will help you heal from your friendship PTSDs, and it will allow you to open yourself up to new experiences with new people. And I can tell you, the fact that I'm open to new friends and so on has enriched my life so much, and I enjoy my life with friends now. Yeah. And today I have one of my friends who I love so much. She's come all the way to visit me. We're gonna be popping, dropping, popping champagne, all that stuff that we love. Then I changed my mind, she's having her lashes done. Maybe if she's so I change cute. The way I love it. Maybe if I try to be. A girl is never too fancy for some McDonald's fries, right?
Yeah.
We are hungry. I think your hands are. Do you want a wife?
I'm?
Yeah.
I'm married.
Oh, you want a second wife?
Second, I want, but my wife made problems.
Oh, no. No.
Yes, I have children.
Oh.
Okay, girl, you're killing it.
You got
purple. Oh, even the back looks great. Let me see that. Let me see a little promotion for the front of the dress. Oh, let's see for the back of the dress, honey. Okay. I have found new ways, but no, can I be the one that you need? Then I changed my mind. Some pancakes, right? Way I romanticize my life and relationships with men, I do so in friendship. And with every breakup, I learn to love the next person better. So cheers to every friendship breakup that made me a more romantic friend. Do you know what I'm looking forward to? Us jumping in the lake and then going to the sauna.
Woohoo!
Look at your hair. Oh my God.
Coming right.
Oh, I'm here with my gorgeous friend. We are going for dinner now. I'm really enjoying our evening together.
Me too.
And I'm so happy you came here.
Me too. I'm so happy you hosted me.
Go. Let's go eat some food.
Let's go eat and get drunk.
And listen, by the way, I'm wearing the same dress as yesterday. You'll have to learn to mind your business. Like, you just have to learn to do that. Like, that's something we're working on, but I'll give you some time.
Why are we going to do this?
So you can focus something else than my dick.
Are you talking about your dick?
Have you seen her video? Have you seen her video? She's focused on my dick.
I'm good.
Show her in the film.
I got the most important part.
His biggest dream
is okay. When you're nominated first, is that going to figure out how it's going to stand in the newspaper tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Two black girls and four white guys.
That's
Black Lives Matter. That's a match if we die.
When the Ouija.
In Swahili, hakuna matata. Okay?
Yeah, yeah, hakuna matata, yeah.
Let's do it.
Friendship.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because like if you're not friends, then what are you?
Right.
I feel like that's like the base level.
That's right, and I almost feel like friendships is the is a base that also helps us to learn who we are in romantic relationships.
Yeah. Exactly.
Even though sometimes people fear that they become more of friends in a relationship than lovers, but I think that's beautiful.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything wrong with being friends in a relationship. I think it's great.